tablets, and a lot of the things that Alan said resonated with why I want to present Padlet with you. So what is Padlet? It's a virtual wall, a little bit like if I say Pinterest, then I get 50% of it, or more than 50% of the audience. I got a lot of the audience here. It's a little bit like Pinterest for education, where people can express and share their opinions, thoughts, ideas, photos, and images. And I'll show you later on, I'm going to go through why I would choose it. So it's a place for students to collaborate and share ideas. So what you might do is post a question, and all the students can contribute to this pin-up board, and you can have it come as a feed which flows as they go, or you can have them show up in a grid, or they can sort of free-form place them on the board. Or you can just brainstorm something, so kids brainstorm, and then they write their different ideas down, and if you've got a free form, you can sort of move them together and collect them. The other thing that I really use this for is safely sharing information with students. As we've said, you Google something and you get hit by, 100,000 results. And I sort of have that picture there. It says, getting information off the internet is like taking a drink from a fire hydrant. I'm sure you're familiar with that saying. So when students do have a project, I will often pre-research for them. And I know in the lower grades, up to year 3, 4, the students are supposed to, especially in humanities, choose from pre-selected sites. So it's a lot easier way to find appropriate sites for your students. You can share photos, and you can also share videos. And while I'm talking about videos, I recommend safeshare.tv. Because if you link to a YouTube site, you often get commercials. You have no control of what commercials are. You get little pop-ups all over it. So SafeShare actually removes all of those from your screen. It works for YouTube and Vimeo videos. You can link it to websites. As I said before, I pre-research information for students, and then I'll link the website there so they can either view that website in a little window or click on it and it'll bring them to that website. And part of the curriculum is students are also required to share information or things in an online environment, part of the digital technologies curriculum and other curriculum. So this is a safe way they can do it in a closed environment. So other features, it can be private, so you've got password protected, so someone can only view it if they have the password. You can have a link, so someone can view it if they have the link, or it can be public and searchable. And also, when students contribute, or you have your Padlet, you can have it that students can only read the content on there, so if you want to present information and just have them read it, or you can make them write on it, and similar to Seesaw, you can moderate it, so as students contribute to a discussion or collaborating together, you can approve the post before it appears on that Padlet. You can access it via a QR code, which is what I've done, similar to Seesaw. The kids just hold up their iPad or their Mac and they scan the QR code and it opens the Padlet up for them. And you can also create, and so that's a QR code there. You can also create your own URL. So rather than padlet.com, that's my name, it'll have 1T57E. So rather than that, you can just create your own URL for it. You can export your Padlets as well as an image, a PDF. You can print them out. So if you've done a big brainstorm with the kids, you can print them out so the kids can have a copy. You can export it. You can send it via email. And if you, depending on your purpose, you could also share on Facebook or Twitter or any of those social media. All right, so I'm just going to show you an example that I've done. I use this one. Hope that opens up. Yeah, I use this one at a conference. What's the good word? Enter the password. Cool. So I haven't used it on Cheryl's computer, so it knows that this is not Cheryl's computer or my computer, so it's asking me for the password. Hopefully I remember the password. Lucky I looked at it today. If not, I may have to switch computers or quickly change it on my thing. Ah, yes. So, here we go. So, what can I do on a Padlet? Now, it's flooding, I've changed the resolution. So, you can write text, and it hasn't changed, but your Padlet can allow you to write text, you can post a question, ask students to respond on the page, it's a collaboration space, more than one person can write on it. So what I get the kids to do is write their name in it and put their contribution there so I know who's done it. So we've got inserting links to websites. For example, if I want kids to use National Geographic Kids or I want them to find interesting facts about humpback whales, then I just post a direct link to that website. You can put photos in there from your iPad album, if you're using the iPad app or the Android app, directly from your device. So students could take photos of their work and post it as well. It's another way of sharing. You can also put videos onto it. Yeah, I'm just going to see how this is fitting in because the controls. Okay, so I will just actually log in on Cheryl's computer. I think it's my first time along. Hopefully, I don't have to. My password? Yes, I'm logged in. Okay. So, if you have found another Padlet that you like, you can copy it by Remake. I know Tim's copied one of mine and remade it and used it for something. When I want to share it, so I have controls over my privacy, so it's private, password protected, secret. I can change those settings in here, so my password, those with access, so this is where I can control what students can do, so they can moderate, and I think it's just because of the resolution you can't really see the others, whether it's read-only, so here they can read it. You can add contributors, you can select whether you want people to copy your Padlet or not, and whether it requires moderation before people actually contribute towards it. So, Helen didn't know how to make a QR code, but this also creates its own QR codes as well. So all I do is click print code, and then it opens up a new window with the QR code, and I just can right-click and save it. So it says this Padlet is password protected. You can embed it in your blog or website, there's different ways. So, as I said before, you can save that image, save as a PDF, and other ways of sharing it. This guy can close. All right, some of the settings. Here I've got a background of a chalkboard. The title. So it might be, I'll just show you some other examples later on of some that I've done. That shows up here, the layout. Freeform, can they just place it anywhere on the screen? Grid, does it automatically show up as grid, or does it stream as students write comments and it appears and it scrolls down? So you've got all sorts of different wallpapers you can have as a background, but you can use your own. There is a premium subscription if you really want to, but I've never needed it. And this is how you change the URL. I'll just show some examples then. Of some of the ones I've done. So, when you log in, you have your dashboard, and that shows some of the most recent interaction with your Padlets, and some of the most recent ones you've done. So, for example, I'll show you one that I did. So, my students are doing persuasive writing, so because they're writing on a difficult topic, I pre-researched a few websites for them. They had three topics to choose from, and then I pre-researched some websites they could use to find information for their site. So I've used it in that way. So they click on the picture, and I'll open up the website. Another way, I've just some old ones. Now I don't show the Katie's. One for also recounts. I wanted the students to do a bit of inquiry learning, so So I set up a few lessons on what is a recount. So I found a few different videos that had examples of recounts, the structure of recounts, and then I could get them to actually answer questions on what they discovered. Then in the second lesson, I think it started playing. In the second lesson, they looked at some of the grammar and the features, and then they were able to answer questions, and we had discussions about that later. So if you're doing inquiry-based learning, it really helps as well to pre-search some of the websites for them. So here I've put a QR code for that page, so if students need to access it, I just showed it up and they scanned off the QR, the Padlet itself. So there's just lots of ways you can share information. I've done the same digital systems. The students were doing inquiry on different parts of computers, so I pre-researched a whole heap of websites for them, a couple of videos and things, and they watched them, and then they recorded what they had learnt about those different things. So adding, I'll just go back to a blank one. Sort of skip that part. Let's go back to here. So to add something, I can simply just click anywhere on there, title, hotspot, and then this is a link to the Seesaw app. Then I could record some audio, I could record a video, or I can attach one, take a photo, attach a document. So then I'll do www.seesaw.com, I think, seesaw.com. And then I do this, HTTP. So it gets you a bit of a preview of the site when it loads, sometimes takes a little while. And then you've got that hyperlink in there. Then if students too, they want to add something, there is an iPad app you can use as well. They can add just different kinds of things. You can choose something you want to add, so you can upload a Word document or a PDF or a file and things like that, or take photos. So I just find it's a really good way of sharing information, collaboration between students, and doing that in a safer environment, and rather than just getting the kids to go and Google something themselves. Are there any questions about Padlet? Anyone from Bunbury got a question about Padlet? We must be in and out over there. All right. That's us done.
Yeah, you got one,
right? Question.
Oh, you got a question.
This one. You had mentioned before that you can use Safe Share.
Yes.
So you have a YouTube video and you link it. How would you actually make it so it still comes up as Safe Share?
All right, so when you go into Safe Share, it generates a URL, a hyperlink, and you take that hyperlink and you insert that into the thing. It'll open up on that Safe Share site, remove all the ads and all that other sort of stuff that's linked to it.
Ben, this is not free for schools.
Padlet's free. You can have a subscription service, but usually when you have a subscription service, it's all extra backgrounds and changing themes and all that sort of stuff. So, like all the ones, the only paid one you really need to pay for is Book Creator. I think Book Creator Lite, you can create one book of 4 pages without paying for it. The Book Creator app was $8, I think it's down to 4 once you get the volume purchase, and Book Creator is going web-based as well. But for the rest, Padlet and Seesaw, you can pretty much use everything you need it for without paying for it.